Good morning, evening, afternoon, almost afternoon, friends. Welcome to game number 14 of the 2019 WFTDA North American West Continental Cup. I am Loose Change.
I'm Kent Smith, a.k.a. Kent the Politician.
Okay, so this is game number 14. We are on day number 3. We are super excited to see Rocky Mountain Fight Club take on the Adelaide Roller Derby Adelaides. Both of these teams have played at least once. Adelaide has played twice. Rocky Mountain played once. What kind of rankings are we looking at here, Kent?
So Rocky Mountain is ranked 40 in the world and came in as the number 4 seed. Adelaide from South Australia, ranked 60 in the world, came in as the number 10 seed. As Loose Change said, both of these teams have played and both of these teams have lost. The difference is Adelaide won their first bout against Jet City, 163-118. They then played Sun State and lost 211-79. Rocky Mountain, in the first bit of drama that unfolded here in Happy Valley's home track, lost to Happy Valley. They led for 58 minutes, but ended up losing 155-150.
Our time very, very quickly disappeared. So go ahead and roll through the Rocky Mountain Fight Club.
Rocky Mountain roster is number 1, Pink Flame and Go, 13, Jersey Whirl, 16, Southern Discomfort, 31, Fiona Grapple, 37, Disaster Risk, 86, Assault and Pepper, 88, She Who Cannot Be Named, 215 is The Captain, Sylvia's Wrath, 357, Martinez, 617, Harper Bazaar, 737, Daisy Danger, 777, Sissy Rinkshaw, 0260, Motorbutt, 1034, Riot Earp, we are underway, 1337 is Nerd Rage.
All right.
This is Pink Flame and Go.
Yep, Pink Flame and Go out there with the star for Rocky Mountain Fight Club, going up against Trinket number 119, but that is Pink Flame and Go picking up lead right in between turns 3 and 4. A little bit of a star stash there for Trinket, but Trinket is through. First scoring pass for Pink Flame and Go, and Pink Flame and Go calling it before Trinket can put any points on the board.
Let me do Adelaide's roster really quick during this break. Number 3, Babe and Pow. Number 04 is Ivy. 13, Lady Ventions. 31, Victoria Bitter. 43, Mad Squeals Mills. 46, One of the Captains, Alcatraz. 52, Pinch Assault. 55, Bobby Dazzler. 91, The Other Captain, Ankle Grinder. 119, The Jammer Who Just Jammed Trinket will hold it here.
And Fiona Grapple out there. Like you talked, number 43, Mad Squeals Mills, jamming for Adelaide in white. Fiona Grapple jamming for Rocky Mountain in black. Fiona Grapple with lead, 2 in a row for Rocky Mountain.
Yep. So, yeah, you see Martinez locking down with, among others, Assault and Peppa. And they push out Mad Squeals Mills. Fiona comes around the outside and tallies the first points of the jam.
Indeed, that initial point scoring pass. And we have a star pass. So person with, that is number 31, Victoria Bitter for Adelaide, has the star in hand.
More points there for Fiona. Yeah, you will see Adelaide pass the star a lot, and we will explain some of why that is as the bout unfolds.
Fiona Grapple coming up to the back of that pack, trying to go to the inside, go into the outside, but being stymied by that wall of Adelaide's blockers, pushing up towards the front. Final two blockers to beat. Nice little pop to the outside is recycling Fiona Grapple back to behind that pivot line. There we go. That is number 2880, Blue Renegade, with that wonderful pop out and recycle.
So, I'm sorry. Yeah, 25 seconds left in the jam clock. We'll see. I mean, obviously the action all holding up right now in turn two. No penalties yet, so both teams still at full strength.
Had to say it, Kent.
Well, I'm sure it's going to happen eventually. But yeah, that is Victoria.
And there we have Adelaide's. That is, like you said, Victoria Bitter threw star on the helmet. cleared that initial pass but did not put up any points. Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple 12 that jam for Rocky Mountain.
Finishing up the Adelaide roster. Yeah, they are Adelaide Roller Derby of South Australia. They are the Adelaides. Number 123, Count to Bumps. 303, Fembot. 314, Cutie. 447, Invader Scrim, who is about to jam. And 2880, Blue Renegade.
So, yes, Invader Scrim out there with the star for the Adelaides. Harper Bazaar out there with the star for Rocky Mountain. Both jammers coming up against that pack as it moves into turn one, starting to get spread out a little bit as Harper Bazaar's pushing at that front and picks up lead for Rocky. That is a three in a row.
Yep, right you are, loose change. And again, another star pass to the pivot. And again, maybe we should just explain this point right now. So Adelaides have four home teams. All right, well, Harper just called off the jam. So again, we'll pick up this Adelaide strategy nuance in a bit, but again, they will pass the star a lot, and it's because the short story is their pivots are jammers in their home leagues. Victoria Bitter, Pinch Assault number 52, Blue Renegade, and yeah, so those are the folks who wear the stripe but also jam in their home league.
Mm-hmm. It's Bobby Dazzler out there doing what Bobby Dazzler does best and dancing on that jammer line, number 55 for the Adelaides. But Pink Flamingo picks up lead over there on that second straightaway.
Yeah, so Rocky has started very quickly, and we should remind everybody that they went 48-0 against Happy Valley. They're currently at 20-0.
So both of these jammers have cleared that initial pass. Pink Flamingo cleared the first point scoring pass, so that's another 4 points. Rocky Mountain sitting at 24 to the Adelaides 0. So thus far we've had 4 jams, 4 leads going to Rocky Mountain. Adelaide not being able to answer anything in respond.
And again, you see Rocky Mountain per their strategy, their usual strategy, is they are going with a three-jammer rotation early on of Pink Flamingo, Harper Bazaar, and Fiona Grapple. Fiona is out there now, and this is
Trinket.
And the first lead jam for Adelaide.
Indeed. So we've got Trinket clearing that initial pass. Fiona Grapple just finally clearing that as Trinket's coming through the pack, looking to put points on the board. And points she does for holding Rocky Mountain scoreless. Right now, we're looking at just under 24 minutes remaining in this first half of the second game of the day. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. We've got number 617, Harper Bazaar, out there for Rocky Mountain. And that is number 43, Mad Squeals Mills, with a star for Adelaide Roller Derby.
We still are penalty free, so that is the second time I've said it in the hopes that someone will blow a whistle.
Just you wait. Harper. Someone does blow a whistle, and that is Harper Bazaar picking up lead jammer.
So yeah, we have a full complement of blockers. You see Adelaide setting up the wall of white in the back, pushing Harper Bazaar out. Again, Mads Squeals Mill still trying to make the initial pass.
Mm-hmm. So both of these packs a little bit spread out as they start to kind of congeal into one massive pack, but Harper Bazaar able to use that to her advantage, picks up 4 points in that first point scoring pass for Rocky Mountain in this jam. Nice little, looks like a pop to the outside is causing Mad Squeals Mills to have to recycle, and looks like Harper Bazaar hit to the inside.
And another star pass to Victoria Bitter, number 31, so she's wearing the star and stripe right now.
Second time Victoria's picked up that star pass, I believe.
But third star pass total? Yeah, third total. Pink Flame and Go comes back out, so Rocky Mountain holding to the three-jammer rotation. Looks like Adelaide early on is going with a four-jammer rotation. Again, the difference between these two teams, at least from an offensive strategy, is Rocky will stick with the three more than likely throughout the entire contest, as they did against Happy Valley. But Adelaide has more offensive flexibility with the pivots, who are home team jammers.
Yeah. So Pink Flamingo out there with the star and lead for Rocky Mountain. Invader Scrim out there for Adelaide. Hot on Pink Flamingo's heels, looking to put a little pressure on that and hopefully pick up some points. But as Pink Flamingo sneaks by, picks up one. Adelaide held scoreless that jam. So with 21 minutes, 20-ish seconds remaining in this first half, Rocky Mountain sitting at 33, Adelaide hanging out at 4.
This is Pink Flamingo's second year with Rocky Mountain. She used to skate with 10th Mountain, which is based in Vail. So Pink Flamingo, a veteran skater, a veteran jammer, but you know, relatively new to Rocky Mountain, but again, she's been in the jammer rotation all season, so you know, both, you know, she's new to the Rocky Mountain family, but very experienced.
Yeah, so Fiona
Grapple
is out there and picks up a lead. Looks like that's actually Bobby Dazzler out there. I know your screen will say Pinch Assault, but that is number 55, Bobby Dazzler, with the star for the Adelaides. I can tell because she has very distinctive hair, and I love her gold helmet. It's always very nice.
She's also the only Adelaide skater in red pants.
Yes.
Which is going to be helpful as we identify folks. Anyway, looks like we've got a rugby match that's broken out in turn three, turn four.
Indeed.
Oh, and the loser in the rugby match, and is this our first penalty?
This is
our first penalty, and it's a jammer penalty on Bobby Dazzler.
So with that, Bobby Dazzler head into the box for 30 seconds. This is going to give Fiona Grapple a 30-second power jam with that beautiful little apex hop there.
Yep,
she
did very well.
She clears it. All of the so everybody else out there, no other blockers in the box, as Fiona Grapple is coming through and just comes up against that wall of Adelaide's in white.
Fiona. We'll see if she gets credit for 12 points on that pass. She gets credit for 11.
11.
So that is her second double-digit scoring jam. Fiona has only scored in double digits, or she hasn't scored at all. Because if you can't go big, why?
Right. I mean, go big or go home.
And so we're going home.
And Fiona is not ready to go home yet.
So again, Rocky Mountain started 48-0 against Happy Valley. They start 44-4 in the first 11 minutes in this bout.
All right. So with that whistle, Harper Bazaar starts as the only jammer out there as Bobby Dazzler finishes the penalty. But Bobby Dazzler, released from that box, barrels through, picks up lead.
Oh. And tried to make the jump, but got taken off her skates by,
I think it was Assault and Peppa. Yeah. So we've got a star pass now for Rocky Mountain.
That's Martinez.
Martinez took a lot. I felt like Martinez was the main person to take the star passes.
Right, you are loose change. Yeah, in the Friday bout, Martinez was the one who was likely to get the star when she was wearing the stripe. 2 points there for Bobby Dazzler, who began that jam in the penalty box, and we would like to thank. Make your skates your own with custom-colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. The WFTDA would like to thank Rydell Skates for their sponsorship of the 2019 Continental Cups.
So Trinket is out there with a star for the Adelaides, but we've got Pink Flamingo for Rocky. Pack is spread out, and there we have it. Trinket picks up lead. And there's Pink Flamingo clears that initial pass as well.
I think this is the second time that Trinket has gotten lead. I get the thumbs up from
our wonderful,
Bobby Narco.
Wonderful producer, Bobby Narco.
And we should point out, Bobby Narco, head announcer or one of the main announcers for Gotham.
Yes.
I'm Kent Smith, Kent the Politician. I call for Burning River, Roller Derby in Cleveland, and the Chicago Outfit. You?
Yep. I am Loose Change, and my home league for the WFTDA is North Star Roller Derby out of Minneapolis, Minnesota.
All right. We've made all our home fans happy. Now we can go back to making the Adelaide and Rocky Mountain fans.
So while we were making our fans happy, the Adelaide jammer was assessed a penalty.
Yep.
So this is a power start for Fiona Grapple. And in just seconds, Fiona is through that pack and picks up lead. So this is our second jammer penalty for the Adelaides here now.
Fiona's the one who's been able to tally double-digit scoring points.
Yep.
In fact, this is the first time the penalty box is kind of full. It looks like we've got, I mean, we're kind of blocked out by the Adelaide bench, but it looks like it is one Rocky skater, and now Adelaide is at full strength.
So as jammers coming through trying to make it, Trinket obviously released. Fiona Grapple still out there with the star working through that pack. Both of these jammers, you know, looking to put those points on the board. And Trinket finally clears that initial pass. So Fiona Grapple already on her scoring pass.
Yeah, it was really good defense earlier by Cutie against Fiona Grapple. Cutie is, and again, this is one of the fun storylines of Adelaide. Cutie, number 314, who will play in the pack, is the daughter of Trinket, who will jam number 119. And both Cutie and Ivy, number 04, are junior skaters who have aged up. Now, they're both in their 20s, but they both actually played at the 2015 Roller Derby Juniors World Cup.
We
have an official timeout.
Okay.
So let me again thank Quick Bearings. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick Bearings, where precision meets performance, Loose Change.
I love precision and performance. So tell me a little bit more about kind of like the jammer rotation that we've been seeing so far, Kent, and like who's got the most points at this point? Because, I mean, you know, out of Rocky Mountain, they're sitting at the 48, Adelaide sitting at 8. So we have a 40-point differential.
So Fiona's the leading point scorer for Rocky with 27 points. She's gotten the lead 75% of the time. Harper Bazaar with 12. Pink Flamin' Go with 9. Again, they will, barring injury, most likely go with a three-jammer rotation throughout the contest. I don't even know if they broke rotation against Happy Valley. I think they did once. I think one time Harper was supposed to go up and she didn't. But
I feel like there was one point in time when we were like, oh, that's supposed to, it's supposed to be this person's turn, but
right,
it's not. They're not there now.
Right. And so, yeah, I think one time Harper sat an extra turn. Adelaide has a total of 8 points. We are stopped with an official timeout at this point. Trinket has 6 of those and has gotten lead 50% of the time. Pinch Assault, who is one of the pivots who will jam, has 2 points, but we think that is mislabeled because we think that was Bobby Dazzler who did that.
Yes.
Okay, so the...
So we were just told...
We had an official's timeout, yep, and it was to correct an officiating error, and we're not terribly sure what that error was, but it's been corrected, so it's no longer an error.
Exactly. With the whistle, we are back to it. Number 617, Harper Bazaar, out there picking up lead.
Mad Squeals Mills, the jammer for Adelaide.
Yep, Mad Squeals Mills working through at the front of that pack. Last couple of blockers to beat. Goes to the outside, able to squeak by. And, you know, so now here we have both in point scoring eligibility. And there we have it. Harper Bazaar. Taking home 4 and calling it off.
So we got a clarification as to what the timeout was, the official timeout. Rocky Mountain actually had a penalty rescinded.
Oh.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we are 14 minutes, 44 seconds into the first half. Rocky Mountain has 0 penalties so far. Adelaide only has three. Normally you would say three penalties in 15 minutes is really good, mm-hmm. unless the other team has zero. Invader Scrim going up against Pink Flamingo.
Yes, so a little bit of a foot race there towards the front, but that is Invader Scrim that gets out first. But just enough that, you know, Pink Flamingo was able to get ahead of her. One of the wonderful things about our vantage point is, you know, as we see Invader Scrim coming around, she just shakes her head at her bench and calls it off.
Right.
Says, I'm not even going to bother with it.
Bobby Dazzler jumping up and down. Bobby Narco tells us that was the first scoreless jam of the contest. That jives with my score sheet as well.
Okay. So, like you said, we've got Bobby Dazzler out there and Fiona Grapple. So, look at that. And Bobby Dazzler picking up lead for the Adelaides.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple's still kind of stuck behind that three pod of Adelaide blockers.
Yeah, Blue Renegade out there for the Adelaides, holding back Fiona Grapple, among others. The action's all in turn two. A little hard to get those numbers at this distance.
So Bobby Dazzler, you know, lead on point scoring pass. Well, looks like we've got a pivot for the Adelaides. Number 31, Victoria Bitter, heading to that penalty box. But our jammer, number 31 for Rocky Mountain, Fiona Grapple, clears that initial pass. Bobby Dazzler up on toe stops on that inside line, picking up 4 points in that second pass, 8 points in total.
Yeah, so Adelaide doubles their score there.
Woo-woo.
Bobby Dazzler with the largest jam of the contest for Adelaide. Again, Fiona Grapple has already put up 2 double-digit scoring jams, 1 a 12, 1 an 11. But again, they were at 44-4, mm-hmm. then they were at 48-8. Now it's 52-16. Again, we've seen Rocky Mountain start fast. Speaking of starting fast, there goes Harper Bazaar very quickly out to lead jam. But again, we've seen Rocky Mountain start fast in both of their bouts so far at the Continental Cup, and then it just slows down a little bit.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you know, what's going to happen? Trinket was out there for the Adelaide Roller Derby with the star, not able to put any points on the board, but that was 4 points for Rocky. So as we, you know, just cleared that 12-minute mark, Rocky Mountain sitting at 56, Adelaide at 16. Pink Flamingo out there with the star. I enjoy the fact that I can always recognize Pink Flamingo because she stands basically a head taller than everyone else. I don't even need to look at her number.
The Rocky Mountain team is a tall team.
They are, and she's just taller.
Yeah. So back block call, and that is the first jammer penalty.
Yeah, first jammer penalty for Rocky Mountain. Mad Squeals Mills out there for the Adelaide at the front of that pack on that outside line, able to pick up lead.
Bit of a celebration as she came through turn three, headed into turn four. 40 points the difference. We are under 11 minutes to play. They, Mad Squeals Mills attempted the jump, but was taken off her skates by She Who Cannot Be Named.
Yeah.
That is number 88.
Nice little communication out there on the track as Mad Squeals Mills wasn't totally sure where to come back in and getting that assist from the rest of her teammates.
Track cut, and Pink Flamingo goes back to the box.
Ooh.
So back-to-back jammer penalties.
In the same jam.
Right. And we did see Pink Flamingo get pick up, oh my gosh, that was a huge hit. Going to get the number as soon as I get it so that it ends in a 3. I think that was Jersey Whirl. It was.
Whew. Mad Squeals Mills taken off the feet.
Yes, she does not want to visit New Jersey again with that kind of contact.
No. Okay, so a couple of folks heading into the inside pack, or excuse me, inside track. Oh, doesn't look. I was kind of expecting for a timeout or an official review to be called, but not now.
That is the fifth time Adelaide has jammed. We're about ready to, has scored points in a jam. We've just started jam 17.
Invader scrim out there, number 4474, the Adelaides, as Pink Flamingo in that penalty box, but standing, so less than 10 seconds remaining.
Martinez, the pivot, goes to the penalty box, and Pink Flamingo comes out.
With that, Invader scrim clears that initial pass, coming up, trying to pick up some points, pushing at the front of the pack with two final blockers from Rocky Mountain to beat. Takes that outside line, able to get past, and picks up four.
Yeah, I think that was Sylvia's Wrath. Again, that was in turn two, but it was Riot Earp, and I think it was Sylvia's Wrath. Couldn't quite get the other number.
So as looks like... just quick glance at that penalty box. I can't see. It looks like it's empty. So Pink Flamingo is back out on the track, but she is stuck behind three. Not totally
that
sure.
That is Cutie. No, that's Cutie. That's 314. That is a Trinket's daughter. And another penalty on Pink Flamingo.
So this is three penalties in a row over the last two jams. So one more time, the next jam will be a power jam for the Adelaides as Pink Flamingo starts in that box.
And this is their biggest scoring jam, this 9 points supplanting the 8-point jam. So again, Adelaide, good defense, good penalty kill. We've got a timeout taken by Rocky. And again, this is, we compare this to Rocky's bout on Friday, where again, they start 48-0, and then they just seem to lose the concentration or intensity, but the other team starts to either figure it out or Rocky takes their foot off the gas a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But we are at the 8-minute, 9-second mark. Adelaide is on a 20-4 run over the last four jams.
Nice. Okay. Well, that's when you're Adelaide and you're sitting at 28 points and Rocky Mountain's at 56, that's 29 points in total? I don't know.
And if you want to follow along with live game updates and matchups, you can do so at stats.wftda.com. You can forecast the game results and keep up with who's playing whom when and see how this weekend's event affects live rankings, all at stats.wftda.com.
Yeah, you don't have to rely on me to give potentially incorrect math numbers. You can visit stats.wftda.com and do all of the math yourself, because I don't have a calculator in front of me and my brain doesn't always.
And we are underway. Bobby Dazzler dazzling away from the jam line. Pink Flamingo dazzling away in the penalty box.
Bobby Dazzler at the top of the pack. Last couple of blockers as the pack is stretched all the way from turn two into turn three. And the last two blockers there need to release Bobby Dazzler, and Bobby Dazzler picks up lead.
That was Jersey Whirl and She Who Cannot Be Named. Rocky Mountain, again, with the three jammer rotation that they hold to, they have an 8-blocker rotation that they hold to fairly strong as well. And Pink Flamingo is going back to the box for a track cut.
Oh.
Holy smokes.
So, this is... At this point in time, if you're Rocky Mountain, there's...
Official review being requested by the Rocky coach.
I'm gonna hypothesize that this official review is going to be in regards to the penalty for the jammer. I don't know.
Yeah, we'll see.
I'm just shooting fish in a barrel.
Obviously, we will be able to get a report from the inner circle that you see there on your screen. Let me introduce the coaches. Obviously, we kind of ran through the lineups really quickly, but coaching for Rocky Mountain are Mark, Coach China, SB, and Betty Vader. And here goes the... Okay, so...
I was wrong.
Rocky Mountain is requesting a back block on the by the Adelaide Jammer. Did we get that right, Bobby Narco?
Might have been a truck that I didn't hear a shack.
I thought it was back block.
Yeah,
we have headsets on, they're kind of far away. Voices, other sounds.
So again, what's interesting is they're not protesting the penalty that mm-hmm. sent Pink Flame and Go to the box for the fourth time. Anyway.
In three jams.
So Adelaide's coaching staff, CD, Slappendecker, and Easy Kill. Again, Adelaide will... okay, so we just heard the no call stands, and Rocky has lost their ability to request an official review. And we've got a power jam start with Jammer Mother Trinket.
Mm-hmm. So we've got Trinket out there. Trinket doing a really good job, picking up lead, grabbing some points. And so with that whistle, we are out and away. Pack positioning itself towards the back a little bit as Trinket is pushing at the front.
And let me point out that Fiona Grapple is wearing the stripe.
Indeed.
So Pink Flame and Go, what we've seen is Pink Flame and Go now standing in the penalty box as Trinket comes around on her first point scoring pass. Pink Flame and Go has had the star in her hand during these last couple of jams, and mm-hmm. one of the three Rocky Jammers is wearing the stripe. So we'll see if that star pass occurs, and it just
has. There it
has.
Is. So new Jammer, Fiona Grapple. Pink Flame and Go finally able to get rid of the star.
Yeah, nobody happier than Pink Flame and Go.
Not at this point in time. Meanwhile, Trinket still out there looking for some points. Picks up four, calls it off, and holds Rocky Mountain scoreless.
Yeah.
So with that, we've got a 21-point difference.
That was exactly what I was going to say. So, yeah, we've gone from a 40-point difference at the 19-minute mark. In the process of the next 13 minutes, that has been narrowed to 21. This is a matchup of the 60th-ranked Adelaide Adelaides and the 40th-ranked Rocky Mountain Roller Girls.
Number 4-3, Mad Squeals Mills out there jamming for the Adelaides. But Harper Bazaar, number 617, also with a star for the Rocky Mountain Fight Club. Both of them stuck behind, the other team's pack.
Yep.
As they roll through turn two over there. But, oh my goodness, there we have it. Mad Squeals Mills picks up lead, able to find that inside line. Harper Bazaar.
Star in hand.
Mm-hmm.
Pushed out there by Victoria Bitter.
Recycling a little bit to that apex area and coming back against that three wall of Adelaide blockers.
Motorbutt out there with the Salt and Peppa trying to hold back Mad Squeals Mills on her first scoring pass, and she gets pushed out and calls it off, but secures the 4 points.
Indeed, those 4 points go up 39-56 as the points differential slowly closes as we roll towards halftime.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain's been held scoreless over the last five jams, and again, that's from the 10-minute mark, so it's five and a half minutes so far.
First four jams, Adelaide's were held scoreless. The last five jams, Rocky Mountain has been held scoreless. Invader Scrim out there for the Adelaide's with the star, and that is
Fiona Grapple,
thank you. Fiona Grapple with the star, but that is a back block penalty being assessed to Fiona Grapple, and a forearm penalty being assessed to Invader Scrim.
So this jam's going to run the full 2 minutes. Fiona gets paroled early by the Utah governor for good conduct there in the penalty box. Under 4 minutes to play, but again, this is going to be a two-minute jam. We got a minute and a half remaining, so we'll see. Fiona's got the double-digit scoring jams, and Rocky really needs some points right now. Mm-hmm. Loose change.
So Invader Scrim released, obviously spending the same amount of time in the box as Fiona Grapple with that little jammer do-si-do. Both jammers looking to clear that pass in hopes of picking up points. Fiona Grapple, first one on that inside line for four in the sky. But here we have Invader Scrim up on that toe stops on the outside line, trying to push past that lovely little tripod of Rocky Mountain blockers.
Yeah,
in the front.
Daisy Danger out there with Jersey Whirl, and I think that is Riot Earp. It is.
So right now, this is our first two-minute jam of this contest.
Yeah, with no lead.
Both, I was going to say both have scored points, but that is not correct. Fiona Grapple's got 4 points up there, and looks like another four to be joining that.
Yeah, 20 seconds left. Fiona coming around on her third scoring pass. Invader Scrim on her first scoring pass. So you're right, Invader Scrim has probably tallied points. They just haven't gone up yet. But another easy pass that time,
so
as the
easy
jam clock is down to single digits. And this will be the third double-digit scoring jam of the half for Fiona. And yes, Invader Scrim does get some points.
There we go. Yep, there's those 4 points for Invader Scrim.
But yeah, the lead had gone from 40 to 17. So Rocky really needed, because again, we saw at the end of the first half against Happy Valley, Rocky, their offense kind of collapsed. They went in the final 10 minutes, they only scored 4 points in that first half.
Yeah, so official review being called by the Adelaide Roller Derby, Adelaides. So with that,
let me remind you that if you want more information about the WFTDA Continental Cups or their hosts, that's what the internet's for. You can visit WFTDA.com/cups.
There is still two more Continental Cups that are happening. The North America.
Oh, on the Rocky East Mountain Jammer.
Okay, we missed that.
I think it, again, 100% hypothesis, because I didn't hear it. It sounds like they're trying to get a cut on the Rocky Mountain Jammer.
Yeah, we know that obviously Adelaide is the team who asked for the official review, and the focus seems to be on the 12-point jam of Fiona Grapples. So they're looking for a penalty.
We will get actual official confirmation, obviously, from our wonderful producer, Bobby Narco, when the officials let him know.
We also have the 2019 WFTDA.
The no-call stands. Adelaide does not retain their official review.
There you go. So if you heard that, and we think you did, the no-call will stand. So we are at 2:09, no change in timing or points or penalties. And we are about ready to get underway with the final 2 minutes and 9 seconds of the first half. Bobby Dazzler going up against Martinez. So the first change in the jammer rotation happens here.
Ooh,
and
yep.
Interestingly enough, Pink Flamingo is wearing the stripe. So
yes,
perhaps this is a change in strategy based on, and a track cut penalty on Martinez.
So with that potential change in strategy, however, that also means Martinez is the jammer. Martinez picks up that penalty going to it. Bobby Dazzler picks up lead for Adelaide.
Right.
You know, when you're looking at a 25-point difference right now and you're Rocky Mountain, you don't want to see a lot of jammer penalties happening.
Yeah, and again, curious that, obviously the strategy was we were going to put Martinez out to jam. We're going to put Pink out as the pivot in case she needs help. And then Martinez picks up the jammer penalty.
So Martinez out of that penalty box with star in hand. However, it appears that Martinez has passed Pink Flame and Go. But Bobby Dazzler.
No, she is star still in hand. Martinez has escaped the pack. Pink still wearing the stripe as the pivot. 8-second difference between the jam clock and the period clock, less jam time. So this will not be the final jam, as Bobby calls it off right there.
Indeed, and Bobby able to put 5 on the board for Adelaide.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. No, 5. You're right. I'm sorry.
48 for Adelaide, 68 Rocky Mountain, and we've got a 20-point game.
Trinket, Mama Trinket, will be jamming against Harper Bazaar. Mm-hmm. Looks like the penalty box is free and clear, so both teams at full strength. 23 seconds on the period clock, obviously 2 minutes on the jam clock.
Yep, Harper Bazaar takes that inside, picks up lead, but oh my goodness, it was just a foot race finish because Trinket is right there behind her. Harper Bazaar coming around turn two with hands on the hips, calling it off. So here we have our second 0-0 jam of the first half. And well, with that, I mean, with that 0-0, that is a 20-point game.
Yeah, so again, it's worth taking a look at Rocky Mountain in the final 10 minutes in this contest versus the final 10 minutes of the last contest. Mm-hmm. When they played hometown Happy Valley, they only scored 4 points in the final 10 minutes. This time, they only scored 12. But again, that's more than how they finished up the first half.
Yeah.
So the difference now, 20 points. The biggest lead that Rocky Mountain had was 40. That was at both the 48-8 mark and the 44-4 mark. The jammer rotation will become a bit of a story for Rocky Mountain just because Pink Flame and Go has 4 penalties. They could bring in Sissy Rinkshaw, or maybe they continue to jam Martinez. Yep. But again, that's the difference between these two teams. Adelaide has more offensive flexibility, and Rocky Mountain much more rigid in both their jammer rotation and their blocker rotation.
Yeah, you know, so I mean, it'll be... Who knows what will be said in the locker room at halftime. And
what the final 30 minutes will bring us, because obviously there's a few different storylines that are unfolding. We'll just see which ones unfold. Mm-hmm. And that's why you should stick with us for the second half. I'm Kent Smith, a.k.a. Kent the Politician.
I'm Loose Change, and we've got Bobby Nurko over there as our producer.
And you should come back in about 12 and a half minutes.
All right, friends, welcome back. Here we are at the second half of game number 14 here on day number 3 of the 2019 North American West Continental Cups here in lovely Orem, Utah with the WFTDA.
Yep. Yeah, so...
I'm just so excited to be here with you, Kent. It's been a blast.
Wait, it's been fun so far, and plenty of storylines have unfolded in the first half. So you're watching Rocky Mountain, ranked number 40 in the world, coming in as the number 4 seed to the Continental Cup West, North America West Tournament. And they lead by 20. Their lead had been 40 about 10 minutes into this bout. They are taking on Adelaide, who's ranked number 60 in the world, wearing white, and they are the number 10 seed. The difference is that Rocky Mountain has already been upset by a lower seed, and Adelaide has already upset a higher seed. So the question is, what's going to happen these next 30 minutes? In the first 58 minutes of Rocky Mountain's first game, they led, and then they lost by 5 to hometown Happy Valley.
In the final 2.
Right, in the final 2 minutes. So we're not really sure what to expect. Again, some jammer penalty trouble with Rocky Mountain. Pink Flame and Go has 4. Mm-hmm. And so we will see. Rocky Mountain is very regimented, in their jammer rotation and their blocker rotation. And Adelaide has a lot more offensive flexibility. The screen now goes to the action, and we will get underway with Trinket jamming against Fiona Grapple.
These are the two jammers that they've used a lot.
Fiona's been the most successful, and that's important to point out. She's got 3 double-digit scoring jams, and obviously if you pull those off the board, it's a tie bout.
Indeed. But so Trinket picks up lead, finds that inside line, gets through, picks it up. Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple finally clears that initial pass as well after being stymied by those Adelaides in white. But here we have Rocky Mountain. Couple of points picked up, and it is called 3 points there for Adelaide Roller Derby, holding Rocky Mountain scoreless in jam number 1 here of the second half. So here we have Pink Flamingo out on the out on the jammer line with the star for Rocky Mountain.
And she's already in conversation, as you can sort of see in your screen, with number 357. That is Martinez, who often receives the star and jammed one time in Pink's rotation spot.
Yep. Mad Squeals Mills out there with the star for Adelaide. Mad Squeals Mills picks up lead in seconds.
Yeah, second lead jam in a row. Mm-hmm. And it took Adelaide a long time, as Rocky Mountain started the bout very quickly. Took a long time for Adelaide to just get second lead jam in the first half. They've already done it in two consecutive jams and have tallied points, both three in the first two jams.
Second verse, same as that first. Pick up lead, pick up 3 points, call it off, hold Rocky Mountain scoreless. So here we've got Invader Scrim going up against Harper Bazaar.
Yeah, Adelaide has, again, they've passed the star frequently as their pivots are home team, home league jammers back in South Australia.
Yep. And, I mean, when you've got that kind of depth, then absolutely, you know, when you're in a Continental Cup situation like this, you want to use it.
Good defense by Riot Earp pushing out Invader Scrim, and that helps get Harper Bazaar out in front, first lead jam of the second half for Rocky.
Yeah, so we've got Invader Scrim out there. Looked like Invader Scrim was going to get through, but popped to the outside. Invader Scrim clears that initial pass. Looks like we've got a Rocky Mountain being called to the penalty box on a forearm.
Riot Earp.
And Harper Bazaar calling it off, puts one on the board for Rocky, but does hold Invader Scrim scoreless. So with 27 minutes and some change remaining, Adelaide at 54, Rocky Mountain 69, 15 points.
And we should say that with the exception of the jammer penalties on Rocky, they had six. Both of these teams were very penalty light.
Yes.
Not many at all. I think it was 5-9. And again, six of those nine for Rocky were jammer penalties. Bobby Dazzler now going up against, and this is the first time we're seeing her, Sissy Rinkshaw. Mm-hmm. So Rocky Mountain, four jams in, has extended their jammer rotation.
Bobby Dazzler fights through. Actually, last person there on skates was, I was going to say their pivot, but is now their jammer with that star pass, Pink Flame and Go. So we've got Bobby Dazzler as lead as Pink Flame and Go is coming up.
And that strategy proves effective in with the star pass to Pink, because it minimized the amount of points that Adelaide got to just one.
Yes. So, I mean, one of the things that you had been talking about in seeing Sissy Rinkshaw starting to warm up with them is whether or not we would see her with the star.
Yeah. Fiona Grapple now wearing the star. She is the high-scoring jammer for Rocky Mountain going up against Trinket. Trinket is tied for second in terms of points, and Trinket gets lead jam.
Trinket follows through and gets through, and here we have another star pass for Rocky Mountain. That is she who cannot be named now as jammer of note for Rocky Mountain. Meanwhile, we've got Trinket working through a couple last blockers to pass, but calls it off, doing what Adelaide's been doing best so far. Gets lead, picks up 3 points, and calls it off. And with that three, we've got 11-point difference.
And again, one of the storylines that we put out there is Adelaide would be more likely to pass the star.
Yeah.
And in the second half, it is Rocky who is passing the star when they don't get lead.
Mm. So we've got Mad Squeals Mills out there with the star pushing at the front, picks up lead, but Harper Bazaar wearing the star gets through, clears that initial pass. So both point scoring eligible now. Will Mad Squeals Mills pick up 3 points and call it?
She attempts to call it. She did attempt to get her hips around a motor butt and given three points, and we are down to 8 points, and that is the most narrow margin since Well, I mean, Jam won because it was 4-0 and then it was 16-0. Pink Flame and Go back out. And Adelaide looks confident. Their bench is up and cheering. Rocky Mountain's bench is sitting. You can kind of feel that Adelaide feels like they're on to something. We'll see if it continues.
So I will say one of the reasons Adelaide bench was standing is because the single ladies song was playing, and that is the Adelaide's theme song because it's all the Adelaide's. But using that Adelaide song power, Invader Scrim picks up lead, and we've got Pink Flamingo out there with the star for Rocky Mountain.
Yeah, Invader completes her, doesn't complete it, but she's on a scoring pass. You know, it's interesting. Again, outside pack ref made a call. Pink looked whether or not she was being called for something.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it is 4-point difference, 23 minutes. 13 seconds. Bobby Dazzler, who does dance before she jams, is out there, and Adelaide can feel it. Rocky Mountain has scored, since we have a break, a timeout taken by Rocky.
Yep, team timeout.
You know how many points Rocky Mountain has scored in the first half? Or, I'm sorry, second half?
Let's see, how many points Rocky Mountain? I'm going to guess 0.
1.
Oh, 1.
Yeah.
I love when I'm wrong.
It is 14. No, I'm sorry. It is 17-1 as Adelaide has opened up the second half.
So here's the question. Will Adelaide be able to continue with the intensity?
Yeah, no, that's it.
You know,
that's
that, it. That they've been able to bring to this first half thus far. I mean, when you think about it, A, they've traveled very far. We're 5,000 feet up in elevation. I don't know what the elevation is for where Adelaide Roller Derby's from. So could that be a hindrance? Could that be a helpful? I'm not sure.
Well, they've only played 3 games,
mm-hmm.
and played 1 a day. So
yep.
they've probably been able to recover. But it is, you know, it's the 4 seed and the number 40th team ranked in the world
mm-hmm.
that has got to find something within themselves right now. Because
yeah.
they're, I mean, you can't have 1 point in 7 minutes of roller derby and think you're going to win. And Bobby Dazzler gets out in front. It was Bobby Dazzler's birthday yesterday. She is still celebrating out on the track. Fiona Grapple still trying to escape the pack. Bobby Dazzler with the jump puts points on the board. Fiona escapes the pack.
Ooh,
big collision on Martinez and Bobby Dazzler.
Jinx, you're going to owe me a Coke there, Kent. But so
power jam, as we've lost some equipment, but
yeah.
a power jam for a forearm. So Martinez maybe didn't get the better of the contact. We got the better of the referee analysis of the contact.
Yeah. So with that, Martinez hit to the outside, pops all the way back behind number 4-6. That is Alcatraz, one of the captains for Adelaide Roller Derby. Meanwhile, the rest of the blockers for Adelaide just doing their best to hold Fiona as Bobby Dazzler has been released from the penalty box, taking the long way around in regards, but putting the speed on nonetheless. Both of the jammers coming around now, engaging in that pack, starting to split just a little bit here in between the jammer and pivot line. But here we go, 4 points up there for Fiona Grapple in that second point scoring.
The referee had made the back block call. I was unclear who it was going to. Bobby Dazzler goes back to the box. So a double, this could not have happened at a better time if you're a Rocky Mountain fan.
Yeah.
Because, again, you get Fiona Grapple, who's been the most effective jammer so far, albeit she's held down in turn 2, you can see on your screen. Fiona now completes the pass. This will be the biggest scoring jam for Rocky Mountain. And Fiona Grapple has the biggest scoring jam, the second biggest scoring jam, the third biggest scoring jam, and the fourth biggest scoring jam.
I'm gonna see you one there, Kent, and say this is the highest scoring jam, period.
That's true. That is true.
So 16 points for either team. So with Bobby Dazzler in that penalty sound box. We've got...
Can I jump in really quick? So that looks like a very effective timeout by Rocky, doesn't it?
Very effective.
Harper Bizarre now going up against Bobby Dazzler, who is in the penalty box.
Yep, so we've got two blockers, one released from Rocky Mountain, from in the penalty box, one released for Rocky Mountain, the other one being released now. So full contingent of skaters out there. Bobby Dazzler picks up lead, but is a
He's called for a track cut.
So with that, we're seeing a little bit of turn of the tide.
That was a tough hit. I'm sorry.
So in the first half, there was a little bit of a tide being turned in regards to Pink Flamingo with multiple penalties over the same jams. Now we're seeing the same thing happen for Bobby Dazzler.
Bobby's now got four penalties.
Yes, all within the last this and previous jams.
And again, Adelaide's got more offensive flexibility. And speaking of being flexible, Harper Bizarre got crushed on the back straightaway and thankfully got up. Bobby Dazzler now out of the box. Both teams at full strength on the track.
So Harper Bizarre coming up, last blocker. Nice hit there, but Adelaide blocker number 314, QT being assessed a penalty.
Yep.
There's a down skater.
Yeah, and that was the pivot. So, yeah, that jam.
So that jam ends. Down skater is up and rolling under her own volition, which is always good. Not necessarily sure who that was.
That was Mad Squeals Mills, who is in the jammer rotation, yet was wearing the pivot stripe during that jam. No points have gone up.
So all of the officials, congregating, doing the talking that the officials need to do as the rest of the teams are getting prepared, kind of reassessing. We've got one blocker for the Adelaide's in the penalty box. And so I'm just trying to, they're just hanging out kind of in between the pivot line areas, which the Adelaide's have enjoyed doing and utilizing the pivot line in their previous bouts. So
this scoreboard says this is a timeout. I think this is an official initiated timeout.
Official timeout. It says so. In yellow on there.
Not up on the scoreboard I was looking at. But thank you, Loose Change. Right you are, Loose Change. This would have been back-to-back. So the referees have huddled. We now have the alt ref coming over to have a discussion with the scoring table.
Still not seeing any points.
Right.
Happening. So
we're
still kind of waiting on that. So, but with the clock stoppage at 19 minutes, 12 seconds, Rocky Mountain 85, Adelaide 69.
The WFTDA would like to thank Rydell, Radar Wheels, Powerdyne, and Rollercon. WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by the Radar Halo. Switch to the Radar Halo today and see why the Halo is the best-selling wheel in Derby.
So we've got more additional conversation happening out there that we're not part of, but that's okay.
It's an Adelaide coach, as you can see in the left-hand side of your screen, having a conversation with some of the officiating crew.
Right hand?
That's the other right. Correct. Thank you for... Loose Change is in charge of directions.
While we have this, let's go ahead and, because our officials are wonderful and we love them.
Oh, yeah, good.
Chemical Restraint, Elder Hormon, Queen Catitude, Darth Bling, Fickle Bitch, Apron, Molly Horman, Rex Blocker, Ricochet, William Moore, Chunk Rock Girl, who just did her 600th
yesterday.
Strong female character, Dilly Gaff, Maria Von Slapp, Evie Does It, Nacho, and Recordian, followed by Little T-Rex.
So you saw the referee, the head ref, talking to the Rocky coaches.
Yes.
The conversation concluded with the ref saying thank you. So perhaps that was a polite warning to benches about contact. But again, no change in penalties 4 points. Mm-hmm. And speaking of points, the high-scoring jammer, Fiona Grapple, out in front and gets lead jam for Rocky.
Yes, Trinket out there with the star, working and trying to make some magic happen for the Adelaides. So with that, we've got the first scoring pass for Fiona Grapple. Trinket still kind of stymied and stuck behind one of the Rocky Mountain blockers. I want to say it's Motor, but I'm not totally sure, so don't quote me on that.
And interestingly, again, Pink Flame and Go is wearing the stripe in this jam. Fiona Grapple out there. This is just the second lead for Rocky in the second half. We are in jam number 10. And so, jammer on jammer contact there. Fiona sending Mama Trinket into out of bounds in turn four.
Just as Trinket is almost clear of the whole entire pack, she just gets sucked right back in and has to try to regroup herself and get past those blockers of Rocky Mountain yet again.
Blue Vengeance is wearing the stripe for Adelaide. Trinket has a star in hand. Is that Blue Vengeance? I believe it is, 2880.
So hit to the outside. Trinket is recycling behind that pivot line. Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple at the front of the pack gets hit into the infield, inside track, whatever you prefer to call it, and has to recycle. But that does give Trinket the ability to make that initial pass.
And Pink Flame and Go finishes that jam
by heading
in
to
the penalty box. And I'm misnamed 2880. It's Blue Renegade. Ah. And I know this, but I made a mistake.
So 12 points there picked up for Rocky Mountain. Adelaide held scoreless. So we're 97-69.
Another double-digit scoring jam by Fiona.
Yep.
Second double-digit scoring jam in the last three jams, no less.
So Invader Scrim is out there. And Harper Bazaar is out there.
So again, over the first 10 minutes of roller derby action in the second half, Rocky Mountain had scored 1 point. Since then, they've scored, I think, 38. But I'll let Bobby Norco do the math. Invader Scrim is the jammer against Harper Bazaar. Invader has already got lead.
Yep. Invader's got the last blocker to beat, and beat she does. So that is 4 points.
There's a mistake on the scoreboard. They've not reset the jammer score, and we've got a penalty on a Adelaide skater. That is Ivy. Ivy is one of the two skaters who skated in the 2015 Junior World Cup.
Yep.
Pink Flame and Go now out of the penalty box wearing the stripe and now receives the star from Harper Bazaar.
So with that, we've got whistles being called, and there it goes. Timeout being called by the officials, probably to see about fixing some things. We will give them that chance to fix it. But so with those 4 points for Adelaide, 8 points for Adelaide, 77 to Rocky Mountain's 97. So we are back to a 2-point difference.
Hopefully they will reset the jammer tally on the scoreboard that you are seeing on your screen. But 8 points there for Invader Scrim. So in terms of Adelaide scoring, very balanced, 21 for Bobby Dazzler, 20 for Trinket, 17 for Invader Scrim. High points, as we have pointed out, for Rocky. 67 of the 97 belong to Fiona Grapple.
So we have Bobby Dazzler out there, number 55, with a star for Adelaide Roller Derby. We also have number 31, that is Fiona Grapple, with the star. Assuming we have no fancy switcheroos after this official timeout happens, they will be your jammers. We've got the pack hanging out at the pivot line. Aw, showing the pivot line some love. That's great. 2010 called, wants its roller derby back.
Mad Squeals Mills has not been in the jammer rotation. She's wearing the star over on the Adelaide bench, but she was the one who got kind of piled up there in turn four that at the 19-12 mark that ended with an injury timeout. So we'll see when Mad Squeals Mills comes back into action.
So, Fiona Grapple takes a lead after clearing that pack. Bobby Dazzler star stash, but does not pass it. Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple able to put 4 points on the board for Rocky Mountain, taking them over that century mark at 101, as well as holding Adelaide scoreless in that last jam. So last couple of jams, Adelaide's been held scoreless.
Mm-hmm. Over the last two jams. But Mad Squeals Mills is back in the jammer rotation, which is good to see. Obviously, she left with an injury, had to sit out a few jams, but glad to see her back on the track going up against Harper Bazaar.
Mm-hmm. And again, we've got the pack at the pivot line. Both jammers come in, both kind of heading towards the inside.
That is not Harper Bazaar. That is Sissy Rinkshaw. My bad. I saw the 7 and assumed it was 617. It is 777. This is the second time Sissy has jammed, both in the second half.
Yep, so with that, we've got both of the jammers kind of piling up on that pack as it is a thick pack rolling towards turn two. We have lead jammer.
Goes to Sissy.
Sissy. However, big hit there. A couple of big hits. Sissy recycled. Mad Squeals Mills, not lead, but has cleared that pack first. I was just watching the jam refs trying to make sure, see if there was any points being awarded.
Yeah, and you see on the screen, you might have seen high fives between the Rocky coach and Sissy, because Sissy got lead jam, and they let the clock burn, even though Mad Squeals Mills got out of the pack. Again, they were trying to take time off the clock. Time is on the side of Rocky.
We've got 447 Invader Scrim out there. And 617, there's your Harper Bazaar that you love, Kent. Harper Bazaar picking up lead jammer. Invader Scrim still stuck behind the last little two wall, but clears it. Both of these jammers in point scoring eligibility now, as we've got Harper kind of hit to the outside and calls it off. 1 point there for Rocky, holding Adelaide's score. You know, one at a time, realistically, that's all Rocky needs to do and run that clock for this last 12 and a half minutes if they're hoping to take home a win.
Yeah, so there it's 12:30 right now. And again, we would remind folks, not to make you Rocky Mountain fans nervous, but you led for the first 58 the last time you were on this track. Fiona Grapple, who has the top five scoring jams for Rocky Mountain, now jamming against
Trinket.
Yep.
Trinket out there. One of the, again, we've talked about how effective these jammers have been, but these blockers have been just amazing. We've got wonderful little tripods and quad pods happening of both of these blocker teams, and hit to the inside, hit to the outside. Right there, we see Fiona Grapple having to recycle, but that does give Trinket that lead jammer.
Yeah, it took her 25 seconds to get there, and again, you'll see Pink Flame and Go wearing the stripe in case Fiona gets into trouble.
Beautiful little inside side surf happening there by Trinket, picking up 1 point additionally and calling it for Adelaide.
And that was really good defense there by Rocky Mountain, minimizing the damage of Trinket to only 1 point. Again, the pack exchanging high fives as they came off.
Harper Bazaar going up against Mad Squeals Mills. Doesn't look like we have anybody in the penalty box, so a full contingent of skaters out there as they roll back towards the jammers. Whistle sounds, and the pack is all, but that is Mad Squeals Mills. Lovely little hop on that inside line and picks up lead. Harper Bazaar clears that initial pass now as well. So it is going to turn into a little bit of a foot race. Who's going to pick up points? Are we going to run it? And Mad Squeals Mills calls it off, but does pick up that full contingent of 4 points for Adelaide. So we are back towards a 20-point game.
Yeah, good tandem defense between Jersey Girl and she who cannot be named. But yeah, they yield the full four.
Invader Scrim going up against Fiona Grapple. Last few, you know, basically the second half, they've really been utilizing that pivot line to start with. And of course, as I say that,
they roll back,
back to the jam line. So with that whistle,
wow.
Oh my goodness, beautiful outside toe stop work there by Invader Scrim, picks up lead as she comes around turn three and four, just a big smile on her face. So gonna try for some additional points. Meanwhile, Fiona Grapple through that pack as well. But, yep. Invader Scrim picking up some points and calling it. One point, excuse me. I thought there was more, but it's one singular sensational point there for Adelaide.
Pushed out by Motorbutt. Good job by Motorbutt to, again, minimize the damage. And you see Sissy Rinkshaw come back to the jammer stripe for the third time in the second half.
Okay.
It'll be interesting to see, and Pink Flame and Go is wearing the stripe.
Mm-hmm.
Again, Pink sitting at five penalties. Martinez sitting at four. Nobody else, well, I'm sorry, Bobby Dazzler, who's out there jamming, has four.
Yes. So with Bobby out there, you know, we've got both of those jammers really just stuck at the same spot. Sissy Rinkshaw trying to play a little bit of defense. I saw a whistle, and it kind of looked like Bobby Dazzler was going to be exiting the pack, but she is not. Bobby stuck behind the last couple of blockers at the back.
And now escapes.
Yeah, escapes exactly. Picks up lead. Meanwhile, Sissy Rinkshaw still stuck there, but do my eyes deceive me?
The star has been passed to Pink Flame and Go. She is now pushing herself into the front straightaway and escapes the pack. Bobby Dazzler is past her, so points go up for Adelaide, but both of these jammers on a point-scoring pass.
Indeed. So now here we have, is Bobby going to call it or try to pick up some more points? And it looks like, Pink Flamingo on that outside line pass almost just unscathed for 4 points. And here we see, there it goes. Bobby Dazzler calling it off.
And so I wonder if part of what the Rocky strategy was to try to get Pink out of, a bad, you know, kind of a mental funk because she'd committed so many penalties in such a quick period of time that they put her out at the pivot to get her out on the track, have her not be the focus of Adelaide's defensive attention, but just let her get her vibe back, because that is the first points that Pink has scored in the second half. And if they're going to close out Adelaide, if they've got Pink firing on all cylinders, they're going to have a better chance to do it.
Yeah. And talking about from that psychology side of things, you know, not only Pink Flame and Go, but you've got Martinez then, who's riding high, and you also have on the other side of things, Bobby Dazzler, who, you know, has the kind of that same thing with being able to say, gosh, you know, there's picked up a number of penalties kind of all around the same time. So just as a heads up, we did have an official timeout, and then we rolled into a Rocky Mountain-led official review.
So here's a fun fact about Adelaide.
Yeah,
Their roller derby roots, and we're seeing the ref is now talking to the two coaches. I wanted to try to yield my commentary if she was going to go for a mic. But Adelaide's roller derby roots come from Austin, Texas, and Smarty Pants is involved. Adelaide was founded.
After review, the officials agree that the no call stands. Rocky Mountain does not retain their official review.
There you go. We believe you heard that on the broadcast. The no call stands. Anyway, Adelaide founded by Barrel House Bessie, who first saw roller derby in Austin and moved to Adelaide and brought it back. And Smarty Pants actually attempted to recruit her. Now to the action in 2019.
Number 119 Trinket out there wearing this star, going up against 617 Harper Bazaar for Rocky Mountain.
And Trinket finds daylight on the inside.
Indeed. Picks up lead just fast as a whippet. Meanwhile, I'm trying to figure out. There we go. So at the top, and with clearing that initial pass, there we have Harper Bazaar as point scoring eligible. Meanwhile, Trinket at the top with a final one or two blockers to beat, and beat she does. So that is 4 points on the board for Adelaide. Trinket attempting, going to run it. Another 4 points as she clears that final blocker. Meanwhile, so we've got Harper Bazaar, who's just stuck and stymied.
And you got two of the Junior Cup players, Ivy and Cutie, holding down the pack.
So both of these packs real slowly moving and just trying their best to, you know, stop the jammers from getting through. A little bit of recycling towards that front. We've got one Adelaide blocker head into the penalty
box. That is Cutie, a forearm penalty. That helps get Harper Bazaar through, and points go up for Harper Bazaar. Trinket pushed out on the inside and calls it off. We'll see if she gets a portion of the four, waiting for the referee signal.
So Trinket did have two full point scoring passes.
11 total.
And there's three more. So that crests Adelaide from that 100 point mark as well. So now Kent, with those 4 points that was scored for Rocky Mountain, this is a 9.
Yeah, so now one of the things you look at now is clock stoppages.
Yes.
Rocky Mountain has one. Adelaide has them all.
All of them. Adelaide also starting this jam with a little bit of a pack disadvantage, as they've got two blockers in that penalty box. But when you've got that happening, you want Fiona Grapple out there. You want Mad Squeals Mills out there. And Fiona Grapple doing what Fiona Grapple does best, picks up lead.
Yeah, and that was the right time for Rocky Mountain to get lead, because that the 11-point jam was the biggest scoring jam of the contest for Adelaide.
One blocker back on the track from Adelaide, but Mad Squeals Mills pushing at the front of that pack and just can't seem to get past those last couple of final blockers for Rocky. Who takes that inside line? There's lots of people looking down at that. Skates.
That's the initial pass, and that is the second point scoring pass. We'll see if Fiona chooses to run it. She does. Again, if you're going to ride any jammer, if you're Rocky, this is the one you want to ride. Fiona's had a tremendous, again, let's remind you, she's got 79 of the 118 points.
I mean, if you're Fiona Grapple, A, you've got to be feeling good about what you've done so far and just wanting to keep skating and keep picking up more points. Meanwhile, Mad Squeals Mills being held up over by turn one by the great quad pod of Rocky Mountain blockers. Still not on that, and hasn't even cleared the initial pass yet.
30 seconds remaining in the jam. Fiona coming in for her fourth point scoring pass, which means she has secured another double digit scoring jam.
I thought I just saw a hat move, but Fiona Grapple.
She took the star off. It is star in hand for the Adelaide jammer. Fiona completes another scoring pass and now is at 16. Blue Renegade is the pivot, and she is one of the hometown jammers, but that star pass was not able to be made between Mad Squeals Mills and Blue Renegade, and that is a huge jam. It was a 9-point difference. It is now 21 with 4 minutes remaining.
So, Adelaide able to pick up 4 points, and with Rocky Mountain 16, they've had a couple other 16-point jams. I know they have a number of 12-point jams.
Yeah, Fiona had them all.
Mm-hmm.
87 out of the 126 points. And official review being...
Official timeout. I think that's technically a team timeout. Yes. So it's a team timeout being called by Adelaide. There we go. Just waiting for that wonderful official point. So, I mean, you know, when you're Adelaide and you've got a 21 difference.
So can I jump in?
Yes.
Interesting dynamic, and I wondered if it was going to happen. You run Pink as the Pink Flamingo as the pivot. You help her get her confidence back. You know, she gets some contact. She doesn't commit any penalties. She's been penalty free, you know, arguably since early in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
She is now wearing the star. This will be the first time Pink Flamingo jams since about the 23-minute mark. So she's had 20 minutes of playing the pivot and hopefully getting, you know, her confidence back. And so with a 21-point lead, they roll her back out there as one of the reasons that they're the 40th ranked team in the world.
Invader Scrim out there. Nice little high five and pep talk from one of the Adelaide blockers. But it doesn't do a whole lot because, like you were talking about, Pink Flamingo picks up lead in just seconds.
Yeah, maybe she just needed the rest.
Invader Scrim cleared that initial pass, so coming up on point scoring. But here we have it. Pink Flamingo calling it off. Picks up 3 points for Rocky Mountain.
And again, now we're seeing Adelaide start to use their timeouts because they're behind. Seconds are as precious as points. Pink Flamingo, just a really good story if you're a Rocky Mountain fan, able to get back out there, wear the star, skate clean, put 3 points on the board, and call it off.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, it's the game of 3 points. 3 points here, 3 points there, and that's really what matters. Out there with the star, we've got Trinket for Adelaide going up against Fiona Grapple. Again, I mean, you know, we've got 25 seconds left of this timeout. That could change, but as long as it doesn't, that's who will be rolling.
Fiona Grapple, 87 of 129 points.
How many points has Trinket picked up out of the 105?
Trinket has 32 and is the leading scorer.
Okay.
Bobby Dazzler with 28.
All right.
Realistically, with 3 minutes left, again, Pink Flamingo, as we've well noted, 5 penalties. Two skaters have 4, so no one really in penalty trouble. Obviously, if that changes, we will tell you.
5 seconds has been called. Next whistle is going to start the jam as everybody rolls back to kind of sit on Fiona Grapple. But Fiona Grapple is going to fight like she fight for her life because she wants those points and that lead status. But we've got Trinket at the front of the pack. Fiona stuck towards the back, slow moving towards into turns two.
You said that Fiona was going to fight. Well, they are the 5280 fight club.
Exactly.
And it works. Fiona comes through, gets lead jam designation.
So with that, nice hit to that inside line four. Trinket's going to recycle to turn three. So Fiona Grapple coming up wants to increase that point difference, wants to put more points on the board, but she's going to have to get past that three pod of Adelaide blockers. Meanwhile, at the front of the pack, we've got Trinket, who finally makes that initial pass, clearing from the rest of those Rocky Mountains, so they can go back and assist. And assist they do. Fiona able to get through, pick up some 4 points.
Yeah, she picks it up and calls it off. Very interesting move in the pack by Adelaide. Victoria Bitter actually took the stripe off, or at least played with the helmet cover, and for a moment there, that froze the Rocky Mountain pack as to whether or not there was a star pass.
Mm.
Haven't seen that done, so that's an interesting kind of, you know, bit of deception that obviously could perhaps work in your team's favor.
Yeah, so Adelaide, again, using all of the clock stoppages that they have. So this is their final team timeout. They do still also have an official review that could be used as a team timeout if they decided to do that.
28 points separate these two teams. And this was, if you're a Rocky Mountain fan, and I hate to bring it up again, this is when you lost the lead. You held it for 58 minutes in the last contest, and you are at 2 minutes and 18 seconds. Again, you have a 28-point lead, and it was down to at the 2-minute mark, at the 3-minute mark against Happy Valley, it was a 6-point lead. So they're in better shape now, and they're in strong shape with Fiona Grapple wearing the star.
Indeed, Fiona Grapple out there again. Mad Squeals
back-to-back jams for Fiona.
Out there. Mad Squeals hit to that inside. Fiona stuck on the outside looking for a little assist by number 357, Martinez. But as the pack is spread out, that is Mad Squeals Mills taking that inside line, picking up lead.
And Martinez went to the box, and she's wearing the stripe in this jam. So Fiona will have no one to pass it to for the next 25 seconds or so.
So Fiona Grapple getting through, calls it as.
No, Mad.
Oh, that was two. Okay, so
yeah,
two
Mad
points.
Squeals Mills called it.
Yes, as Fiona was coming through, able to hold Rocky Mountain scoreless and pick up 2 points for themselves for Adelaide.
And Adelaide, if you're going to use that timeout, you should use it because clock, you know, points or seconds are ticking away.
Oh, but if you're Adelaide, it doesn't matter because it looks like Rocky Mountain is going to use their last team timeout. So with 1 minute 16 seconds remain, Rocky Mountain sitting at 133, Adelaide at 107. That's 25?
26.
26, thank you, Kent. 26-point differential. All right, so we've got a couple of folks on Rocky Mountain with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, one person, and one, two, three, no, sorry, there's two people on Rocky Mountain that have 5 penalties. On Adelaide, the closest is one person with 4.
So that's the first time Rocky's been held scoreless in the last 5 jams. So they have gone on a nice bit of a run. They've gone from 102 to 133 over the last 7 minutes of play.
Okay.
Which, again, comparing that to their Friday bout, good to see that they have been able to keep their mojo in the final 10 minutes of play. Adelaide, you got to feel happy if you're Adelaide because you're playing a team that is 20 spots higher.
Mm-hmm.
And you're still
them a run in, for their money. Right,
and I was going to say, and you're still in it. Now, you need 15 points here, and then you need to use your official review, and you need 15 points again. But that is not impossible. Pimp, Flame and Go going up against Invader Scrim. We are underway. Game clock at 105, jam clock at 147.
Pack spread out, but that is Invader Scrim at the front, picking up lead. Pink Flame and Go not too far behind, but being assessed a penalty. So this is going to be a power jam for Invader Scrim.
Holy cow.
This could be what the oh my goodness, no. So Invader Scrim being assessed a penalty as well.
All right, so
we've got a jammer do-si-do happening.
And this is the final jam of the bout because there's no way you can stop the clock now.
Nope.
Adelaide, in theory, maybe didn't need it because Rocky Mountain gave them a timeout before that last jam.
Yeah, so both jammers in the box. Both jammers now released from the box.
Yep.
But it is Invader Scrim at the front of the pack, clearing that for 3 points. Pink Flamen Go trying to work through, still stuck in the midst of the pack.
Able
to break free right there. With period clock ticking down, less than 40, about 45 seconds remain in this jam.
Yeah, it's the jam clock that'll end this jam because the jammers can't.
Indeed, the jammers can't do anything other than score as many points as they can so far. 3 points up there for Invader Scrim, working, trying to get back at the front of the top of the pack. Nice hit to that inside.
Jersey Whirl and Martinez working together, and they've pulled Invader Scrim back into the back straightaway.
Alcatraz just doing her darndest to keep Pink Flamen Go behind them. The whole entire blocking set.
And Pink has done a nice job as we are at 5-4-3. Pink has done a nice job of not picking up the 7th penalty, which she could not have because she would not have been able to come back out on the track. She picked up 6 in the jam. If she gets 7, she's got to sit there the whole time.
So Adelaide using their official review right at the very end.
So, yeah, we are not at a final
score yet,
because Adelaide is going to have a conversation with the referees. Now, obviously, and I don't think any official review outcome changes the outcome.
You know, who knows? I sure as heck don't. But so as it stands right now, Adelaide sitting at 113, Rocky Mountain at 137. Rocky Mountain able to put 4 points on the board in that last jam.
Adelaide is challenging the high block call on Adelaide's jammer.
Oh, okay. So they're looking for a penalty.
A reversal of the jammer penalty that occurred that allowed them to release Pink early.
Mm-hmm.
And again, the final jam, if the score stands, goes 6-4 in favor of Adelaide. But again, Pink Flame and Go did a good job of tallying points, not picking up the 7th penalty, because the 7th penalty would have been just very problematic. Adelaide still would have needed a bit of a point-scoring miracle, but obviously if your jammer cannot return to the track to score points, that could be disastrous.
Yeah. I mean, you need a... you need a jammer to score, but... So, this has been a delightful contest for the 5th and 6th place here at the 2019 WFTDA North American West Continental Cup. Don't worry, friends. You are not going to want to go anywhere because the next bout that we have...
That's right. Coming up at 2 o'clock, we have hometown Happy Valley taking on Evil for the bronze medal game. And then at 4 o'clock, we've got Calgary and Sun State.
Playing for that first place. So our officials are convening, our teams are hugging, and...
Yeah, this is a lot of discussion for a jammer penalty, because this is, I mean, again, they're saying, do you have confidence in the penalty that you called? And we're at 2.5 minutes. Now, obviously, some of that early on is the discussion. Oh, we've got the ref actually informing the coaches right now, as you see in your picture. Mm. And
such a great ref crew. I mean, everybody that has been here, whether it's the officials and the announcers, obviously, all of the staff, all of the photographers have been so wonderful.
And head ref.
After review, the officials have determined that an officiating error had occurred.
Ooh.
The high block call on Adelaide's jammer is overturned. Because the jam ended unnaturally, we will have one more jam.
Of course you will.
There you have it, friends. One more jam. Because why not? I mean, if you're Adelaide, that's what you wanted. Exactly what you wanted.
24 points separate these two teams. Fiona Grapple, who has 91 of the 137, will be the jammer of record. The penalty box is free and clear. So this is an all skate for all the marbles.
Trinket out there for Adelaide, pushing at the top of that pack, spread out, but last couple of blockers to beat on over there at turn two. Meanwhile, we've got Fiona Grapple stuck behind, and there we have it, lead jammer going to Trinket. So with that, again, this will be our one last jam. Fiona Grapple taking a little spill.
Yeah.
Not clearing that initial pass yet as Trinket is coming through, looking to put some additional points on the board.
Star in hand for Fiona. Wearing the stripe is Martinez. Martinez has 5 penalties, so obviously she probably won't foul out. If you're Fiona, you just don't want to go to the box.
And there we have star pass to Martinez. Martinez looking to find that, take that outside line. Ooh. and does.
And she dropped the star when she took the tumble.
And then dropped it again after she stood back up. But it is in hand, not on her helmet yet. Meanwhile, Trinket still stuck behind that wall of Rocky Mountain blockers.
And again, if you're Martinez, you just don't want to take a trip to the box.
No.
We are at we're at 37, 36, 35. No points have officially gone up. Now Trinket's on her scoring path.
Yep.
Rocky Mountain has yet to make the initial pass. So at worst, this is a 4-point tally if you're a Rocky Mountain fan.
And there's that 4 points for Adelaide. We've still got Martinez fighting, takes that outside.
Yep, pushed out.
Pushed out, has to recycle. So as that clock ticks, we've got Trinket coming back to the front of that pack. And those blockers that were just giving her the business earlier.
Martinez escapes the pack, but we are done.
So that is 0 points in that final jam for Rocky Mountain.
In theory, Adelaide could use their official review because they retained it.
Yes, indeed.
But it, I'm not sure what they would challenge. That is an 8 13-point difference.
They're going to take their 6 points to the bank and be very happy with their 119 score over Rocky Mountain's 137.
I was going to say, it's an 18-point difference, and it's still unofficial. But it is now not unofficial. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Championship Sunday at the WFTDA Continental Cup North America West. It's been exciting so far.
It's always been exciting, and Adelaide's such a they're always just so happy to be able to play roller derby as they do their little All the Adelaide's song and dance to cheer for themselves. Oh, my goodness.
Well, and I feel good for Rocky Mountain because, obviously, they had a stinging defeat. They thought they were going to – they knew they were going to be playing on Sunday. Mm-hmm. They thought they were going to be playing in either the game coming up or the 4 o'clock bout because they did come in as the number 4 seed. But so Rocky Mountain ends on a good note, perhaps erases some of the bitterness of the Happy Valley defeat on Friday night. And that is the team that you will see coming up. One more quick just comment about the scoring, because it's important to know how balanced the versatile Adelaide Jammers were. Trinket with 38, Bobby Dazzler with 28, Invader Scrim with 24, Mad Squeals Mills with 23. And there's one name that we need to tell you about on the Rocky Mountain side, and that is 91 points for Fiona Grapple. So you can buy those Fiona Grapple posters now. They're on sale in Denver, I'm sure.
I am sure. All right, friends. Well,
coming up, Happy Valley versus the Evil Dead, and then our championship bout, Calgary versus Sun State.
Yes.
I'm Kent Smith, a.k.a. Kent the Politician.
I am Loose Change, and on behalf of our producer, Bobby Narco, thank you for being here, and we will see you soon.